Thank you so much. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thanks. Thanks. Both of the shows are amazing, and there's space for everybody. I absolutely love Taraji on Empire. She's amazing. That show is amazing. It's room for all of us, and I'm glad that everybody's doing well, and I love both the shows so much.
Fantastic.
The aliens on the radar, on the antagonist. And then if it's like me, getting at me first, and then Adam and the guys are going to save me, and then a couple of other kidnapped victims.
Because we've been working in this world where everything's kind of CG, all the monsters and all.
Yeah, that hats off to Chris Columbus, the director. He can tell you what, you know, this green ball you're looking at, a green pad. He can describe it really well and give you what the reaction would be. And yeah, you know, what else?
Think about working with Adam, and you're working with Josh. You're working with such an incredible cast.
Yeah, we're working with Josh again. Josh is one of my good friends. We work with Brennan Reed together, the comedians. His show with our Billy Crystal. So yeah, always a pleasure, and I'm on Adam Sandler, so to be a comedian looking up to the big homie in a sense, it was a great opportunity.
And what was your favorite moment from set?
Every day. You know, Adam is a guy that, you know, he takes time out to just share stories with you, he'll ask them even about your family. Like, it's not always about work. And he was a very humble guy, so it was great to see a humble superstar like that.
Yeah, this is sort of, in a way, an 80s period piece, I feel. Do you get that vibe?
Absolutely. He's nostalgic about the 80s. He saw the wedding singer, so he was on the Michael Jackson beaded jackets and the hair and the mullets and all that stuff. So he's already in that world.
And on gaming, what were some of your favorite games growing up?
All the ones in here, Galaxy, Centipede, Donkey Kong, Pac-Man, a lot of the asteroids.
What's coming up next that you like to hear?
I'm teaming up again with Marlon Wayans. We did a Haunted House 1 and 2. We're doing another parody movie of
50 Shades.
Yeah. I'm playing his brother in that, so we're working that out right now.
Are you done yet, or you're in the works?
No, we're in the works. It's beginning stages of that.
Well, we look forward to it. I'm sure it's going to be fun.
So it came apart like, you know, normal way. I got the script. My agent said, you know, you should go out for this. And I went out for it, and I didn't know what it was really about. And then I was like, wow, this is such a good script. I need to be part of this movie, you know what I mean? And then when I got my second, third call, I met Christopher Columbus, and he was sitting there. I was like, I had no idea he was directing it. And then I found out Adam Sandler was part of it, and I kind of lost my mind after that. I was like, I need to be part of this.
Yeah, so I guess
yeah, right. Yeah.
Working on screen is like
I'm a pretty hardcore fan. I'm not big into like shooters or anything, but I like adventure games. I like Legend of Zelda. I like Donkey Kong. I like Mario. I like Crash Bandicoot. I like GTA too. I got that violence streak sometimes. You know, I gotta let the aggression out, right? So I'm a video game guy. Yeah, I grew up with video games. Teenager who's proposing to his girlfriend, works really hard to propose to his girlfriend by the Taj Mahal. Right when he's about to propose, he gets kidnapped by aliens or pixelated. Yeah, cock block, right? But yeah, so anyways, at the end, Adam Sandler and his crew finally come out and save me and some of my other buddies, and that's, you know, that's the gist of my role in the movie. Yeah man.
So I play young Sam Brenner, which is the younger version of Adam Sandler. So I played him in 1982. I think I was 13 in the film. And I'm a loser. But as the film goes on, I discover video games. I'm turning out to be very, very talented at these games. So like one of the best in the world. So I go to the championships and play the games.
He's just so funny.
So that's how that turns out for my character. You should probably see the movie to see the rest of the details.
And speak about the games that you had to play in the film, and did you actually play them in real life and learn about them?
You know, on the set, I got an opportunity to play the games a lot, which was really fun. They were everywhere. Because a lot of the sets that I was on included a lot of the classic arcade games. So I was able on my breaks to play them. I was able to play them when we were filming because my character plays them. And they're great games. They're really great games. So I hope a lot of kids get into it now.
So you're the younger version.
I'm the younger version of Kevin, yes.
So speak about immersing yourself in the world of video games.
It was amazing. It was a great experience. I got to play this one and that one, and then it was just so much fun. Like, I got to play Pac-Man and Galaga and everything. It was just so much fun.
What was it like working with Chris?
Chris the Bronx, he's amazingly talented.
Well, we've done a lot of movies together. We did Billy Madison, Happy Gilmore. We're college roommates, so you know, it's very easy to collaborate. So we've known each other for a long time, and it's seamless at this point.
What's next for you?
We got a movie coming out called The Ridiculous Six on Netflix in December. Shooting a movie now in Savannah. I gotta go there next week called The Duel with Adam and David Spade.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
I love the idea of being able to do an original summer movie and a summer of superhero movies and sequels. It was really exciting for me. And I really fell in love with the concept of these three video game nerds who actually were superstars when they were kids, and then their world fell apart because the arcades closed. And we cut to 2015 and they have useless skills and they're really lost in their lives, but the President of the United States needs to get them together to help save the planet. I love that.
And you're no stranger to special effects, but tell me about working with the effects for this particular film.
We wanted to create effects that people have never seen before. Something that would blow the audience's mind. And we really tried to create these pixelized versions of destruction. And I'm telling you, you shouldn't do any mind-altering drugs before you see the movie.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.